Chapter 1, the computer system. In this video, you will be learning about processing device and output device. In the previous class, you have learnt about the computer system and input devices. Let me start.
After giving input, data and instruction goes to the processing device. This is a processing device of computer. This is a CPU. It is also called brain of the computer. That's because it handles the entire computer system. All different software, hardware of the computer are managed by it. It performs various calculations and tasks that makes program work. One of the major functions of the CPU is to take care of the principal storage of the computer. All the data and instructions that the computer needs at the moment are stored in the CPU. This is the temporary storage area which holds all the data and instructions. It is called computer primary memory. And this primary memory is divided into RAM or ROM. Now, let us see what is RAM and ROM. This is a RAM. Full form of RAM is Random Access Memory. RAM is the temporary memory of the computer that holds instruction and data. When the computer is switched off, the content of the RAM are lost. It is just like a calculator. The moment we turn it off, we lose the content. So, RAM is the temporary memory of the computer. As we switch off the computer, it is lost. Now, let's see about ROM. ROM stands for Read-Only Memory. ROM is a computer memory that can permanently store data and application within it. It keeps the data safe even after switching off the system. Even we will switch off the system, the data will be safe. But in the RAM, data get lost. But in the ROM, it is safe. It is a permanent memory. Whereas RAM is the temporary memory. This RAM and ROM we will be studying later on the higher classes. Now let's see about output devices. These are the some output devices such as printer, monitor, sound card, speaker. Let us see one by one. First, let us know what are called output devices. Devices that give us output are called output devices. Once again, devices that give us output are called output devices. Now let us see one by one. This is a monitor. This part I am saying this is a monitor. An instrument or device. It is an instrument or device used for observing, checking or keeping a continuous record of a process or quantity is called a monitor. We call it as visual display unit. It is VDU, that is known as visual display unit. Monitor. A monitor display information in visual form using text and graphic. It shows the result. We see the result on the monitor. It is also called visual display unit, that is VDU. So monitor is an output device. Now let's see speaker set. Speaker are one of the most common output device used with computer system. They are used to play sound. From the speaker, sound used to come out. We used to get sound, so it is an output device. Now let's say about printer. This is a printer. It is also an output device that is used to take a printout of your work done in the computer on paper. We used to get a printout in the form of paper, and this printout is also called hard copy. What is called hard copy? The printout that we get are called hard copy. Now let's see about headphone. This is a headphone. Headphone is also an output device because sound used to come out from headphone. It is a device consisting of a pair of earphones joined by a band placed over the head for listening to music or speech. Now let's see about software. So hope you have understood the input process and output devices. Software. All the programs, files, games, songs, movies, pictures, etc. that we have on the computer are called software. These are not the physical parts of the computer. There are some examples of software are calculator, Gmail, MS Paint, pinball game, WordPad, Scapy, Facebook, Map. These all are the software. Software can be of two types, such as system software and application software. System software is the name given to program file that are required for the proper functioning of the computer. Without system software, computer cannot work properly, such as operating system, system development software, utility software. These are the system software. Without this, computer cannot work properly. For example, in your mobile phone also, or in your smartphone, there is an operating system, such as Android. Without this, your smartphone also cannot work. So in the computer also, without system software, computer cannot work. There are operating systems such as Windows 7, Windows 8. These are the operating system. Without this, computer cannot work. Now let's see about application software. Application software is the name given to programs, files that are used for a specific purpose. Your computer will still work properly if you do not have application software. So, application software is a name given to the program file that are used for a specific purpose. Application software are used for a specific purpose. For example, in your smartphone also, if you want to download any app, you just go to the Google Play and download it. You download for a specific purpose. That is called application software. Thank you. Hope you have understood this chapter.